My name is Stuart Russell, and I'm a professor of computer science at the University of California, Berkeley. The phrase singularity has been around for several decades. It refers to the idea that when intelligent systems exceed a certain level of capability, they would be able to redesign themselves to have even greater capability. In other words, they'll be able to do AI research and computer hardware design. So very quickly, they would then bootstrap themselves to an arbitrary degree of intelligence, would leave us far behind. We actually have the potential for irreversible loss of control. And what consequences that has for humanity, very hard to say. It seems like the problem comes from the way we've conceived of what AI is. The notion of machine intelligence is exactly the same as the notion of human intelligence. So for a human to be intelligent, it means acting in a way that's likely to achieve your goals. So if we transfer that to machines, it's machines are intelligent if they act in a way that's likely to achieve their goals. But unfortunately, that notion of machine intelligence is not the one we want. We want machines that act to achieve our goals. One of the things people worry about with AI systems is their use in weapons. A lethal autonomous weapon is a weapon. You can imagine, for example, a quadcopter that's armed with a gun or explosives or something like that, that has onboard AI, a little bit like a self-driving car, so it can fly around, navigate through buildings, through cities. By and large, the AI community is unified in opposition to proceeding with the development of these weapons. And the principal reason, in my view, is because they don't require human supervision, can be scaled up. One person with enough money can buy 10 million weapons and launch an attack with all of them simultaneously. So that's in a nutshell why lethal autonomous weapons are a terrible idea.